Assalamu alaikum. This is Sayyida Mehwez Zahra of fourth prof. My group is 26. I am represent the topic which is idiopathic rhinitis. So let's start with the topic, which is it is the term for a group of nasal diseases of unknown etiology. Basically, rhinitis is an inflammation of the membrane which is inside the nose. Irritants or allergens can cause this inflammation. There are also times when there's no specific cause for the inflammation. Like it's a kind of disease in which no specific reasons are applied over here. But there are certain other names for this condition, which is non-allergic rhinitis and idiopathic rhinitis. So we are here more focusing on idiopathic rhinitis. Rhinorrhea. Basically, rhinorrhea is the term that will be used in my next slide as well. So you should know the term as well. So it is basically the free discharge of thin nasal mucus fluid. That is a kind of runny nose. Jaise hume zukham wagaira maybe runny nose ho rahi hoti hai, that is same thing in the rhinorrhea as well. So it is enhanced cholinergic glandular secretory activity. Atropine-like agents effectively reduce the secretion. Like if we are using any type of atropine-like agent, so they will basically decrease the rhinorrhea. So that was a little introduction. Let's move to the case study. It is a 29-year-old man complains of profuse watery rhinorrhea that has been a chronic and progressively worsening problem for the past 5 years. He also experiences some nasal congestion with the rhinorrhea, but denies nasal itching or sneezing. So although the symptoms tend to remit and exacerbate, they do not occur in any definable seasonal pattern. His symptoms are worsened by the exposure to tobacco smoke, strong fumes such as paint or ammonia, and hot coffee. And they often are associated with the headaches as well. So the rhinorrhea is substantially worse on exposure to cold air. So a man has no other medical problems and there's no family history for the allergies. He does not smoke, nor he drinks, or either drinks occasionally. So his only medication that is the beclomethasone, dipropionate, which is 42 microgram per spray. 2 sprays in each nostril twice a daily as needed. Only partial relieves the symptoms. This disease basically partially relieves the symptoms. So he also sniffs and blows his nose several times during the medical history taking. Physical examination reveals a mildly erythematous nasal mucosa and a minimally edematous inferior turbinate. Copious nasal discharge is clear and watery and air movement through the nose is relatively good. So there's no sinus tenderness. The remainder of the physical examination is normal. Microscopic examination of the nasal smear demonstrates only a few neutrophils and no eosinophils. So basically here are different terms which are very, you know, new for us. So I will further explain you what these terms are related with. So what information about MS supports the diagnosis of idiopathic rhinitis? Here is a case study. Here I will tell you about the subjects in which we have to mention all the general criteria, which is males, how gender about its gender, age, history, current medications, which is using. So gender is male, age 29 years old, patient complains of profuse watery rhinorrhea. Rhinorrhea, I've already told you, that is a thin nasal mucus discharge. Patient does not smoke and drinks only occasionally. History is patient has no other medical problem and no family history for allergies. What is the current medications he is using? Beclomethasone dipropionate, which is 42 microgram per spray. Object physical examination reveals a mildly erythematous nasal mucosa. What do you mean by erythematous? It is basically, it's a condition in which the nasal mucosa gets swollen, phool jata hai, and it gives the bluish gray color ho jata hai. Like the mucosa swollen and it gives the bluish gray color. and a minimally adamatous inferior turbinate. What is this? It's a condition that can cause the obstruction in one or both sides of the nose. लाइक हम कहते हैं ना जब जुकाम वगैरह हो जाता है तो नजला जम जाता है या वी कैन से देयर इज अ ब्लॉकेज इन द नोज तो इट्स द सेम थिंग. कॉपियस नेजल डिस्चार्ज इज ऑल्सो क्लियर वाटर एंड एयर मूवमेंट थ्रू द नोज इज रिलेटिवली गुड. नो साइनस स्टैंडर्डनेस लाइक साइनस प्रॉब्लम हेड एक वगैरह जो होता है देयर इज नो साइनस स्टैंडर्डनेस. रिमाइंडर ऑफ द फिजिकल एग्जामिनेशन इज नॉर्मल एंड माइक्रोस्कोपिक एग्जामिनेशन जो की गई है तो वी कैन सी दैट इट ओनली अ फ्यू न्यूट्रोफिल्स एंड देयर इज अ नो ईजनोफिल्स आर देयर. असेसमेंट तो फ्रॉम द डेटा इट कैन बी एंटिसिपेटेड दैट द स्टिमुलाई दैट नॉर्मली इंक्रीजेज द पैरासिम्पैथेटिक एक्टिविटी इन द नोज सच एज वी हैव कोल्ड एयर एंड इनहेल द इरिटेंट्स एग्रोवेट द सिम्टम्स. दीज आर सम ऑफ द सिम्टम्स दैट कैन एग्रोवेट द डिजीज. तो the symptoms of the idiopathic rhinitis are variable such as in this case. So the patient experienced nasal congestion with rhinorrhea. The patient also suffered from the headache. Patient report worsening of their symptoms when exposed to non-specific irritants such as tobacco smoke, pains. The appearance of the nasal mucosa is also variable. Next is plan. In the plan, basically, we have patient should be instructed to avoid aggravating factors such as smoking, exposure to very hot or very cold beverages. Person should avoid cold drinks and all the cold ice creams and all these things. Saline irrigation is valuable as a general soothing and moisturizing treatment. What is saline irrigation? It is basically sinus flush. Simple method for gently flushing out the nasal passages with salt solution. Increase and exercise increases the sympathetic tone. Intranasal corticosteroids may be helpful. Decongestants may also improve the nasal congestion. Then we have ipratropium bromide. It's a topically active congener of atropine, may decrease the nasal secretion and is helpful in treating the idiopathic rhinitis. Basically, apart from beclochromethazone, that was the person using the spray, ipratropium bromide is very effective in idiopathic rhinitis. So certain dose I have mentioned here, it is two sprays of the 0.03% nasal solution, 42 microgram in each nostril, that you have to give 2 to 3 times per day. What are the indications who can use this ipratropium? So it is indicated in the patients for the treatment of reversal airways obstruction. Ipratropium can be mixed with other medication, for example, albuterol or saline. It is indicated in the patients who have new or they have worsening kind of cough, bahut zyada coughing jinko ho rahi hai ya jinki shortness of breath hai ya increase sputum hai, it can also be indicated in those patients. कॉन्ट्राइंडिकेशन सेज के किस पेशेंट को नहीं देनी चाहिए लाइक हु शुड नॉट टेक इप्राटोपियम ब्रोमाइड एरोसोल इनहेलर. सो दोज पेशेंट्स हु हैव क्लोज एंगल ग्लॉकोमा, ब्लॉकेज ऑफ यूरिनरी ब्लैडर, दोज विच हैव इनलार्ज प्रोस्टेट दैट इज अ डिजीज एंड सम ऑफ द पीपल हु आर अनएबल टू एम्प्टी देयर यूरिनरी ब्लैडर, दे आर नॉट टू बी टेकन दिस डोज और ड्रग. Side effects are nasal dryness, nasal burning, bloody nasal discharge that is called epistaxis. That is the bloody जो थोड़ा सा नाक से जो हल्का हल्का खून आता है उसको कहते हैं. Dry or sore throat, then we have dry mouth. Here are some important points to be noted that ipratropium bromide is anticholinergic and is available as nasal spray dosage form. The initial management of idiopathic rhinitis should be directed at preventing the symptoms like which can be achieved through variety of pharmacologic and non-pharmacologic methods can be applied in order to stop this disease, in order to prevent this disease from happening. So we have these methods. Then patient must be educated. Patient counseling is very, very important. सो यू नीड टू कीप दिस इन माइंड दैट पेशेंट काउंसलिंग इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट. पेशेंट को पता होना चाहिए कि उसकी क्या डिजीज है, उसको कौन से सिम्टम्स कौन से सिम्टम्स आ रहे हैं, कौन सी चीज़ों से उसको रोकना है. ऑल दीज सिम्टम्स आर ऑल दीज थिंग्स टू बी टोल्ड टू द पेशेंट. तो एलर्जेंस और इरिटेंट मस्ट बी अवॉइडेड एंड अप्रोप्रिएट मेडिकेशंस अलॉन्ग विद द इम्यूनोथेरेपी शुड बी प्रॉपरली फॉलोड. Then we have effective control over idiopathic rhinitis can greatly improve the quality of the patient's life as well. So this was the end of my slide. Thank you so much.